Hello everyone, welcome to the second episode of the series The Linux Command Line Ultimate Tutorial. In this video, you will learn how to manipulate files and folders from the command line. In particular, you will learn how to copy, move and remove files and folders, as well as how to create new files and folders. Let's get started! I hope you remember from the previous episode how to list the content of the current directory. This command ls. So these are the directories which are located in my home directory. You can also see them here on the right with the graphical interface. So let's create a new file. In Linux you need to type command echo, then you type this sign, and let's name this file file.txt. You type ls again, here's our new file, and you can track these changes on the right side with the graphical interface. So now let's also create a new directory. To create a directory you type mk, which is a short of make, and then dir, so it's quite easy to remember. Make directory. And you type a name, new directory, new dir, ls. Here's our new directory, and here's our new file. Now let's copy this file into this new directory. The command is very simple, cp to copy, then you type the file name you want to copy, and you type the destination where you want to copy it. In our case, it's a new directory. So we have copied it, now let's list the content of the new directory to check if the copying was successful. Here you can also learn that you don't need to change your directory to list its content. You can type ls and the path to the directory which you want to check. In this case, we see that file.txt is located in the directory new directory. Again, we can go to the graphical and we can confirm that it is true. But you can also use the command copy to copy the file with a different name. For example, if you type copy file, then we type again new directory and we name it here file2, for example. So we list the content of the new directory again. Now we have two files and you can see them here as well in the new directory. So you can copy a file with its name as before into new directory, or you can also copy it with a new file name. You can also make a copy of this file within the same directory. For example, if you type copy file, then you type file3.txt ls. Now we have two files, the original one and the new which has been just created, with the name free in it. So we have created some files, we copied them into our new directory. But you can also move files. So let's move file 3 into the new directory. You type mv, which is a short of move, very easy to remember. File3.txt, new directory. And again, we check its content. Now we have three files in the directory, new directory. And you can see them here as well. And the move command works similar to copy. You can also move file and give it a new name, as it was here. For example, if we type move file.txt, new directory, file, for example, 0.txt, and we type ls new directory. Now the file has been moved and renamed. So basically you can use the command move to rename files. Let's demonstrate it again. If I go inside new directory and I move file 0 to file, for example, 1.txt. Now you see the file has been renamed. So the move command is used primarily to move files, but it's kind of similar to renaming files as well, if you give it a new name, as I has done here. Now let's learn the command to remove files. And to remove file you can type very simple command, it's just two letters, rm, and the file name you want to remove. for example file.txt. And then we type ls. Now we have only three files. The file.txt has been removed, and you can see it disappeared from here as well. And here I would like you to pay some attention, because remove in the command line removes files forever. For example, in the file manager, you can move them to trash, which is different from removing file, because in your file manager, you can also have a command delete, so delete will also remove files forever. But move to trash just moves them to trash, so you can restore them in the file manager. But in the command line, there is no way to restore it. After you remove it, it will disappear. So be very, very careful with the remove command. We can also remove several files at the same time. For example, if you type remove command, then you put star sign .txt, it means to remove all files which have any name but end with .txt. And all files have disappeared. So now if we go back to our home directory, so we have new directory here left only. So let's remove it. To remove directory in the Linux command line, you need to type command remove dir and the name of the directory. So the directory has been removed. But here you also need to pay attention, because remove directory will only work if your new directory is empty. For example, if we create the new directory again, then let's say we want to create a file inside that directory. We type echo new directory file.txt. So this will create a file within the directory new directory. So let's go back to our home here, and we can check that we have a new file here. You can again copy this path ls, and you can see that it's true. The file is located in new directory. So let's remove it now. If you type the command remove new directory, which is not empty anymore, it will complain the directory is not empty. So one of the ways to remove this directory is to go inside into this directory, remove file. I'm not gonna do that, but if you remove this file, the directory will be empty, so you can go back and remove this new directory. But there is easier way. If you type command remove and you add option R, which means to remove everything recursively, you can remove this directory and all its content. But you should also be very careful with this command, because remember, it will remove these files forever. So before you type it, make sure you type everything correctly and you know that you want to remove this directory as well as all its content. Press enter, you see everything disappeared from here, and the directory has disappeared from our home. I type ls, there is no directory, new directory. And the move command works the same with directories. I didn't show it, but let's do it again. Mkdir new directory, and we will move new directory to, let's say, downloads. SD downloads. Here's new directory inside the downloads folder. We can do it the same in graphical. You can see it's here. And let's say you want to rename your directory. You type move new directory, and then you type new dir2, for example, ls. The directory has been renamed. We had new dir before, now it's new dir2. Don't worry if it's overwhelming for you now. We will be using these commands during the whole tutorial series, so you will learn them. Now you know how to manipulate files and folders using the Linux command line. And from the previous episode, you should remember how to navigate in your Linux system using the command line. In the next episode, you will learn how to open files using the command line, as well as how to get little more information about the files from the command line. Thank you for watching!